today we are going to talk about irradiated foods, also known as radiation processed foods. What is radiation processing or food irradiation? It is nothing but controlled application of ionizing radiations on a product to obtain desired changes in its characteristics. The radiation is in form of electromagnetic rays, which are either from gamma rays, from radioisotope cobalt-60 or cesium-137, or it is machine generated in form of electron beam rays or X-rays. What radiation processing does? It either breaks sufficient number of DNA bonds in pests or bacteria and eliminates microorganisms which can be pathogenic or spoilage forming, or it absorbs radiation energy in the product to form free radicals which introduce chemical and biological effects to stop or slow down the physiological processes. So irradiation, what it does is slows down or stops a physiological process or a biochemical reaction, which can be in form of sprouting, ripening or senescence, which we normally see in vegetables and fruits. The other processes which are used for similar action are low temperature by chemical means or by removal of oxygen, or ultra high pressure. Irradiation also inactivates microorganisms. So these two processes, it can be phytosanitary or sanitary. Phytosanitary is for quarantine treatment, for facilitating exports, and sanitary is for disinfestations. The same action we can obtain by having high temperature, by using fumigation, or by applying ozone, or low pH. There are other specific terms which are used instead of food irradiation, such as cold pasteurization, radiation disinfestation, radiation hygienization, radioradiation, radicidation, rad apartization, and sterilization. These are used for specific instances on different, when it is applied on different products. Radiation processing is a very safe and wholesome process. It has been already endorsed by large number of international and national bodies, which include Food and Agriculture Organization, International Atomic Energy Agency, World Health Organization. And in India, we have Ministry of Health, Ministry of Agriculture, and Ministry of Food Processing Industries, which has already endorsed this. The fact that Apollo 11 mission had carried radiation processed ration with them, this mission was carried out in July 69, speaks volumes for the efficacy of this process. The safety and nutrition adequacy of radiation processing food has been tested for the last four decades. In fact, the various aspects of safety have been tested, which include radiological testing, safety of chemical changes, microbiological safety, and nutritional adequacy. Nutrient losses are less than any other food processing method which are being employed. The animal testing and human trials have been carried out, and number of studies have been done which indicates no adverse effect. More than now 50 countries are using this, including India. Radiation processing has also been endorsed by large number of professional bodies. You can see the list, it's fairly long. And now with this, no doubt is left about the efficacy of this process or safety or nutritional adequacy of this process. One thing which has to be noted is that radiation processed products do not become radioactive. Like a person goes for X-ray, he doesn't become radioactive. Similarly, a radiation processed product does not become radioactive. Applications of radiation processing can be divided into three main categories. It can help in improving food safety by eliminating pathogens and parasites. It can do food quarantine for increasing international trade. It can strengthen food security by increasing preservation, reduction in post-harvest losses, and extension of shelf life. Today, more than 1 million tons per year of food is being processed by irradiation in the world. In India, a gazette notification entitled Atomic Energy Control of Irradiation of Food and Allied Products Rules 2012 has been issued, in which different foods have been divided into five classes, in which the food category is mentioned against which purpose of irradiation and the technological dose range, that means minimum and maximum irradiation dose which can be applied, has been provided. The irradiation dose is in terms of kilogray. 1 kilogray is 1 joule of energy absorbed in 1 kg of a product which is being irradiated. Let us see what are the advantages of radiation processing in food preservation. Radiation processing is a physical, non-additive, efficient one-time process. It is non-polluting, eco-friendly, and doesn't leave any harmful toxic residues in the product. We can treat bulk or pre-packed commodities. Only single parameter control is required. That means only time of exposure is required to see whether food irradiation is complete or not. It is extremely reliable, is a cold process, and preserves food in natural form. It does not destroy heat, labile, aroma, constituents also. Phytosanitary treatment is to facilitate international trade. For this, we have to destroy the quarantine pests which can be there in the crops we have. US is the biggest importer of mango, and which had banned imports from India in 1989 due to quarantine issues. In 2007, US accepted Kushak irradiator for radiation processing of mangoes. Now, even pomegranate has been accepted for food irradiation and for exports to US. Food irradiation has a very important role for food safety. It eliminates different pathogenic microorganisms like Listeria, Vibrio, E. coli, Salmonella, and ensures food safety by eliminating the disease-forming pathogens in seafood, meat, and chicken. In fact, it is a curative control technique and eliminates the entire chain starting from egg, larvae, and pupae. If you see in food safety hierarchy, radiation process gets the pride of the place. If any product is radiation processed, you can assume it to be having highest food safety. Food irradiation controls different physiological processes, which includes sprouting. Sprouting in potato, onion, shallots, garlic, and ginger can be controlled. For this, we have to apply a very small radiation dose by which you can reduce the storage losses which happen due to sprouting. It can reduce dehydration losses. You can reduce the power requirement which is required for keeping them in storage, reduce these supply chain losses, retain market and processing quality by having enough stocks, then stabilize market price. Food irradiation controls another physiological process which is required for shelf life extension. It can delay in ripening, it can delay in senescence. There are some fruits which are climatic type which continue to ripen after plucking it done, like mango, banana, apple, and tomato. So we can delay the ripening in such fruits or vegetables which get senescence. These are non-climatic fruits like papaya, pineapple, strawberry, cherry, grapes, citrus fruits. We can delay the senescence happening in these fruits. Studies have been done at Sri Ram Applied Research Center where they did food irradiation studies on apples. Like apple will have shelf life of 3 to 4 months when stored at 4 degrees centigrade without food irradiation. But when food irradiation is carried out and we applied a dose of 0.5 kilogray, you can extend the shelf life to 9 months when it is stored at 4 degrees centigrade. Or up to 6 months when it is stored at 15 degrees centigrade. Radiation processing can also control mold or fungal growth. An example is of storing lychees. When a non-irradiated lychees are stored at 4 degrees centigrade, you can see the picture, how the fungal growth is there. And when you irradiate for only half a kilo gray, you can see that after 15 days, the leeches are still looking fresh. So radiation processing in combination with low temperature storage can increase the shelf life up to 4 weeks of fruits like leeches. Food irradiation has a big role in eliminating microorganisms for insect disinfestations. Commodities like rice, suji, rava, maida, atta, pulses, dry seafoods, ricins, dried figs, dates and other dry fruits, we can prevent infestations which happen due to long storage. A small dose up to 1 kilo gray is applied and then you can keep these products safely for longer periods. Radiation processing in medium dose applications can control shelf life for products like meat and meat products, chicken, spices, fresh seafood and frozen seafood. We can keep animal origin products like mutton and chicken fresh for longer periods by applying radiation doses up to 3 kilo gray. Radiation processing has lot of applications in fish industry also. You can apply it on dry fish for disinfestation. You can apply it on fresh fish for radiation, on frozen fish for radicidation, and you can also make ambient stable fish products. It can be also used for fish meal and aqua feed for hygienization purposes. Radiation processing can be applied to non-food products, which include dog or pet feed, cut flowers, nutraceuticals, herbal and Ayurvedic preparations, cattle feed, packaging materials and containers. But one needs to keep in mind, radiation processing is not a panacea. It cannot be applied to all foods. For example, it cannot be applied to milk and milk products. It also cannot inactivate viruses. Therefore, when we have to inactivate viruses, it has to be coupled with heat. It also cannot make stale or bad food good. It can be used only for a specific purpose on a food product. The term radiation sometimes creates problem in the minds of general public. So it creates hurdles in consumer acceptance. It is more of a psychological issue. People try to relate radiation with cancer. However, Codex Alimentarius Commission, which sets standards for food worldwide, and World Health Organization and many other scientific bodies have already endorsed it. World Trade Organization has also recognized this as a process which can be applied. So this process is gaining acceptance worldwide. Food safety is the main driver now for food irradiation. There are a number of facilities which have come up. Now today there are more than 200 facilities which exist in the world. In India, economics will be the main driver for success of radiation processing. Here I would like to say that process like milk pasteurization also took more than 50 years to become accepted by public. Similarly, radiation processing is bound to succeed. Irradiation facility is of two types. It can be electron beam based, or it can be gamma radiation based. In gamma radiation, we have two choices, cobalt 60 or cesium 137. Cobalt 60 is more acceptable choice and which is now being used in all the gamma irradiators we have around the world. The picture shows a typical gamma based radiation processing plant. It consists of a thick shielded cell, which is in the form of a labyrinth. We have one inward conveyor and one outward conveyor. Inward conveyor brings the different boxes in which the food products to be radiation processed are brought inside the cell, and outward conveyor takes the boxes outside the labyrinth cell. In the labyrinth cell, we have different layers of the products which need to be processed, and in the middle of that, we have a source frame which will have number of cobalt 60 pencils which will irradiate the product around those pencils. When the products have to be radiation processed, the source frame is front, in front of them, but when irradiation processing is not to be carried out, this source frame is pushed below where we have a water pool with about 7 meters of water over it to shield the irradiation pencils we have. So that can facilitate even maintenance, and a person can enter that cell to carry out the maintenance required. It is a requirement to deliver radiation dose within a range. For that, the product boxes are shuffled and are also moved around the source in different layers. This ensures that every particle in the product box gets a dose within the range specified. This picture gives an electron-based accelerator. This facility exists at Vashi, Navi Mumbai, at the Brit complex. So these facilities are now becoming popular for medical product sterilization. Facilities similar to the gamma-based radiation processing plant, but has much higher throughput, so are more useful for medical products than food products, where dose needed is very small as compared to medical products. If we go further, irradiator types can be divided into industrial irradiators or research irradiators. Industrial irradiators handle large throughputs, and research irradiators have smaller volumes to handle, where you can change the product frequently and stop the irradiation process in between. The irradiators can also be divided into two types, like it can be a continuous one or you can have batch type irradiators. There are certain advantages of batch irradiators. These are simple to operate. They need less area, less capital, can be quickly installed. These are modular. It can take care of all the products which need to be processed. The product in process and irradiation are the same. These are very useful when different products are to be done, as compared to continuous irradiators, in which unless the entire product is out, you cannot send a new product. The batch irradiators are inherently safe also. But there are some disadvantages of batch irradiators. These are less efficient because we have to switch off for changing the product, and the source utilization efficiency is also less because radiation processing is going from only one direction. It is not panoramic. Department of Atomic Energy has set up 3 plants, one in low dose category, which is there at Krushak, Lasalgaon, one in the medium dose category, which is at Vashi, and one high dose irradiator, which is there at Trombay, that is used for sterilization of medical products. Krushak is used for low dose products like mangoes, onions, potatoes, and Vashi plant is being used for products like spices, pet feed, psyllium husk. This slide shows pictures of the radiation processing plant at Vashi, which is in use for the last 15 years. This is carrying out radiation processing of spices, psyllium husk, and host of similar other products which are being exported worldwide now. This picture is of Krushak irradiator, which is there at Lasalgaon. It was commissioned in year 2003 and being used for processing of low dose products such as onions, potatoes, and mangoes. So export of mangoes to US is happening from this plant. The main requirements of a gamma radiation processing plant is that dose delivery has to be within a particular range. That means dose uniformity ratio has to be controlled. The plant efficiency has to be as much as possible. And safety of public and plant personnel has to be ensured. There are different plant parameters which are used in conjunction with gamma radiation processing plant. These are source product geometry, in which we have size of product box and size of carrier within which the product boxes are put. The number of passes the product boxes have to go around the source and number of shufflings in the vertical level the product boxes have to undergo for ensuring dose within the range specified. The product boxes are brought at two different speeds. From outside, these are brought to inside cell at much higher speed to have better efficiency, and within the labyrinth, the boxes are moved slowly so that they get the dose which is desired to be given to these boxes. Importance of safety is there in gamma irradiators. These gamma sources produce very high dose rates during irradiation. If humans are accidentally present in the irradiation area, they can receive lethal dose within seconds. These sources also interact with air and ozone gets generated, requiring proper management. The safety philosophy employed is defense in depth and fail-safe approach. For siting, we select a site where seismicity is within the acceptable levels. Safe distances are kept from public places. It is seen that water flooding cannot happen to that site. Enough biological shielding is provided. Water pool is provided for storing the cobalt 60 sources whenever maintenance is needed. And also multi-level engineered safety features are there. So even if there is a mistake, this plant will shut down in a safe manner. We have seen different facets of irradiation processing, the requirements of food irradiation, the dose ranges, how this irradiation processing is applied. In conclusion, I would like to say, irradiation processing is a very useful process which can be employed in food preservation, safety and for quarantine purposes. Irradiation facilities are very safe and convenient to operate and also very eco-friendly. Around 1 million tons of products are being processed in the world annually. And in India, we have 20,000 tons of products being processed, which is less than 2% of the products being processed in the world. This infestation of cereals like wheat, rice, jowar, pulses, etc., and their products in small packaging, 5 to 10 kg, and having silos where these products can be stored after irradiation, can be a game changer for India. Sprout inhibition of potato, onions, etc. with proper storage also can help in reducing huge losses which are occurring. Shelf life extension of fresh fruits and vegetables in combination with controlled atmosphere and modified atmosphere packaging, etc. also can help in reducing the losses which are occurring in these products.